things are starting to change. The Ministry of Lands has started registering women as part of their husband's properties or land titles in order to save them from the hassle once they separate or even when the man dies. This was revealed by the Minister of Lands, Persis Namuganza, as they launched a report that showed that women by Oxfam UGANDA International.
On several occasions, women have been marginalized on issues of land, with instances of them being pushed off land by their spouses. A recent research conducted by Oxfam International indicates that women have been subjected to illegal and forceful evictions by either their spouses or in-laws, despite many women playing an important role in family land acquisition. Now, the Minister of Land says that they have started registering women's names on their husband's land titles to enable them access the land even when the man dies.
CCOs are our hopes, because other lands we already registered. When it comes to free land holding title, it's not easy to convince a man to improve his wife, daughter, or someone else. But this customary certificate of ownership is something which is still a baby, and we have put their condition as government that if it's a family and there is a woman or there is a daughter, these people have the right to be included on this certificate of title of customary ownership. So I think Oxfam and its stakeholders, we are so appreciative as government, and we are going to use this report which they have made for us out of their research, because it has very good recommendations which we hope as government that it will increase production, because women had been denied rights to use the land freely by men just because they lack legal documents in regard to ownership.
It is said that women still find a hard time to cultivate their family land. Namuganza adds that over 20,000 family land titles have been recalled, and efforts to register them in women's and children's names are underway.
But what we have emphasized as a ministry, where all these certificates of customary ownership have been issued, like Enifade, Ajman, we have emphasized the inclusiveness of women in those certificates of titles. Even where we find the families, it's only women, we have made for them these titles. So the issue here is that we are emphasizing that the women land rights must be recognized.
Many scholars have argued that there is a direct relationship between women and girl children land rights, economic empowerment, food security, and poverty reduction. While women's land and property rights are vital to development, the reality remains that in many parts of Uganda, these rights are often not shared equally between men and women, and are routinely violated, denied, and given insufficient protection and enforcement.
And we found that some of the key factors crippling women's access or securing of the customary certificate of ownership still includes issues such as funding, access to funding. This is still a big issue.